Records was inspired by many things, some musical, some not.
Charles Bukowski,
Bonfires,
Bob Dylan,
Gardening,
I Love Wine,
6 Feet Under,
20 Boxes of Wine,
Twin Peaks,
Every Week.
You don't necessarily have to hear these influences, you just kind of take them on board, you know, it's much to do with somebody's ethics or approach as it is to do with the execution.
Neo Rauch. He's a German painter born in the east of Germany in the 60s. And I grew up in the south of Germany, so I've got that kind of connection. And I just like the way he kind of takes the piss out of this kind of German work ethic, work and you'll be happy. He shows that a lot in his paintings. He's got these workmen who are in these surrealist scenes with these beasts, these otherworldly beasts. That's something between Alice in Wonderland and some kind of nightmare. It's a very strong image. It's got this immediate image, and then you can look further into the scene, and then you can find little stories all around. You know, so many connections in between, and then you can understand that maybe. But there's something you'll never understand, or something I'll never understand anyway. Hopefully, our music does that as well. The best music does it anyway. You get this immediacy, you're really interested, then you can listen back to it again, again, again your whole life, and you'll still like it, you'll still find new things, and there will always be this kind of awe of how did he do it, you know. When we write songs and when Alex writes his lyrics and stuff, there is a certain element of that. It tells a story, and you don't actually understand it. You like the way the words work together and the way the music works together, but a certain thing you don't actually understand, you've got to work yourself into, yeah.
First discovered the Fulcrum at 1992. Immediately it just sounded, it just had so much character and vitality. It's just like a bizarre hybrid of horror, fiction, and rockabilly.
The centimeter square.
Eat yourself better.
Said it purged fear.
Eat yourself better.
I listen to them every other day, so you know, kind of everything I do is musically is informed by The Fall. The Fall are a group with a rotating lineup, which rotates around one individual called Marky Smith. Started out in the late 70s in Prestwich. They're not like virtuosos or anything like that, anybody in The Fall, and neither was I, so in that respect it kind of sort of gave me a sort of renewed confidence to just start a band.
I'm totally wired, son. Totally wired.
Totally wired.
I'm totally wired,
son. Can't you see?
I envy people that haven't heard The Fall yet because it's such a huge body of work to get into, and you know it'll take years out of your life sort of collecting it all, but I mean it's always exciting if it's your cup of tea.
Tony Parker would be best described as a journalist. He interviews people on the, kind of on the margins of society, and then he writes books, publishing the transcriptions of the interviews. And it sounds kind of like very kind of so what, but when you read them, they're just amazing, like insights into human life. My favourite one of his books is called The People of Providence, where he went to the South London housing estate and interviewed hundreds of people, really. Often the first bit of the transcript would be, oh, well, you know, I don't know really what you want to talk to me about, I haven't got much to say, but you want a cup of tea and that kind of thing. And then by the third week, they're like saying, yeah, you know, and then, you know, this amazing, incredible thing happened to me when I was a kid, and it's just like, you're like, oh my God, you don't expect to get there from like this. In the 60s, Tony Parker interviewed women who had been in prison, and it was produced as a television play with actresses playing the parts.
at night when they closed the door and I was all on my own, I used to pull up a chair to the little window, stand up on it, and I could see right over London, you know, right over King's Cross. Oh, it was smashing. If I ever leave here and I go inside again, I'd like to get that cell back.
I think the biggest connection between Franz Ferdinand and Tony Parker would be the kind of the interest in the everyday and the exceptional in the everyday, which is something that is like kind of becomes a theme in Franz Ferdinand lyrics. A song like The Fallen, for example, is a song about people definitely on the margins of society who are living unstereotypical lives but reveling in it. And it's the song is kind of a celebration of that, which is basically what Tony Parker was all about.
Some say I'm trouble boy, just because you like to destroy. Hard thing to bring the idiots to back. Oh, that's why we need a destruction.
I've known Queen all my life because my mum used to have Queen records. They have this huge, overwhelming sense of optimism within the music, and euphoria as well. If you think of that positivity in that song, Don't Stop Me Now, it's indomitable, it's incredible. Like riding on some great rush when you're listening to that, and there's a crescendo followed by a crescendo followed by another crescendo. This music made by people who save a life and take life to the extreme and make you want to do the same yourself as well. To me, the greatest instrument in that group is the bass guitar. You have great riffs on the bass, which you don't always get, but it's at the heart of this fantastic rhythm section. And I know a song that we were doing, like I'm Your Villain, is very much inspired by particularly that later Queen stuff where you've got this very locked-in rhythm, stuff like Another One Bites the Dust. I know when we were getting the band together, I remember thinking about being on stage and being in front of people. I remember thinking, you know, you can do it in one way, you can do it the sort of Dinosaur Jr. kind of way where you shamble on stage and you kind of feel a little bit awkward about being there. Or you can do it the Freddie Mercury way, which is where you bound on the stage and think, here I am! You know it, I know it! And we're gonna really love it, aren't we? And I think, no, that's the way I want to do it.
Everything you see or hear has got some kind of influence on what comes out of you again.
Joe Meek.
Neil Young.
Bicycles. The Silver Apples.
Curb Your Enthusiasm.
The Pub.
Everything is kind of like taken in and worked up and then spat out again.
Lucky, lucky, you're so lucky. 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 Lucky, lucky.